It was a time when planet Earth looked terribly sick. Its air was gray, its waters were full of poisons, its cities were crowded and dirty, and trees and flowers and butterflies and all beautiful things were dying. But even worse, the people of Earth were selfish and greedy and careless and wasteful. Earth looked terribly sad. It looked as if it was crying in space. Now all this was seen by the celestial beings who dwell in the universe, and an alarm arose throughout the galaxy. "Planet Earth in distress! Planet Earth in distress!" was the message heard far and wide in space. Every planet in Earth's galaxy was a different color, so each sent out its own special healing energy to Earth. The beings of the red planet sent courage. Those of the orange planet sent hope. The yellow planet's beings sent understanding. And the beings of the green planet sent harmony. Those of the blue planet sent faith. Those of the indigo planet sent wisdom, and the beings of the violet planet sent truth. But alas, it was not enough. Planet Earth still looked hopelessly dreary and dull. "Special meeting of all planets in the galaxy. Special meeting, all planets." Each planet sent a representative to the special meeting, which was held at the seventh zenith meteor. The meeting buzzed with concern. All the celestial beings were quite upset. They gathered around a magical crystal sphere, which helped them make clear decisions. "Planet Earth has not responded to our efforts," said the being of the red planet. "It's still sad and gray," remarked the orange being. "We gave it all we had," said the yellow being. "What more does it need?" asked the green being. "I think we should just give up," said the being of the blue planet. Everyone stared. No one could quite believe what they had heard. "No," replied the indigo being. "There must be something we can do." Then the being of the violet planet said softly, "There's something missing here." Space grew very quiet. All around, it was empty and dark and silent. Then, a beautiful white glow began to hover above everyone's head. It was the glow of a wonderful idea. "Yes, that's what we must do," all the beings realized at once. "We must come together, all the colors of the galaxy, to blend our energies." But the being of the blue planet said slowly, "I don't think this will work. I must return to my own planet." The blue planet being had lost faith, her very own beautiful healing energy. All the colored beings were amazed. "You must be strong," urged the red being. "We should give it a try," encouraged the orange being. "It will be wonderful," exclaimed the yellow being. "We need you," said the green being lovingly. The blue planet hesitated. Could this really work? "We are not complete without you," said the wise indigo being. "Please join us in this one last effort to save planet Earth." "We cannot come together without you," stated the violet being. The blue being looked around. Suddenly she could feel what the others were feeling. Something was about to happen. "I'll try," she decided. So the planets merged their color energies together and formed an incredible thing. There, glowing with a beautiful rainbow ring around it, was a pure, white, shining sphere. It was the planet of love. At the south pole of this white planet, an energy station was formed. 7 crystal towers to generate rainbow love, the missing magical energy. The blue planet being now understood that she was an important part of this wonderful idea and gave all she had in helping the others. Each day, all the colored beings worked together, played together, sang and danced together on this new white planet, hoping to activate the crystal towers with their love. Before long, they became one beautiful, multicolored family. Then one day, a great vibration was felt, and everyone rushed to the crystal tower station. Flashes of color were rising up in the towers, and then magical colored love beams shot all throughout the universe. Planet Earth became surrounded with sparkling rainbow colors. The people of Earth started waking up, and they wanted rainbow everywhere. They drew them, they wore them. Their favorite gift was to give and send rainbows to each other. And best of all, they started to see the love and light in each other. From outer space, it looked like a wonderful fireworks was happening on Earth. Do you think we've overdone it? Wondered the orange planet being. Do you think we sent too much love to Earth? Asked the red being. Do you think there is such a thing as too much love? Questioned the green being. And will planet Earth still remember to love after all this is over? Asked the blue being, about to lose faith again. Suddenly, a radiant white ball of light glimmered over their heads, then shattered into the colors, and a new being stood before them. It was the magical Rainbow Man. Have no fear in your hearts, the Rainbow Man said gently. I have come as a result of your love together. I have been sent to live in the skies above Earth with these magical colors. From time to time, I will appear to the Earthlings as a symbol of love, to help them remember their true self, which is caring and giving, loving and sharing. All the celestial beings were filled with wonder. All their efforts and love had brought forth this beautiful new multicolored being who would be devoted to helping planet Earth heal. But you will need some help, declared the blue being, her faith renewed. Yes, the Rainbow Man said thoughtfully. I shall gather all the beings of the sky, the ones who dwell closest to Earth, to assist me in my mission. There's Starman and Cloud Dream, Lightning Streak and Sunbeam, the Crystal Goddess, and my little rainbow helpers. We shall help the people of Earth heal their planet with love. But now I must go, smiled the magical Rainbow Man as he drifted towards the Earth. I shall take my magical heart crystal with me as a guiding force to awaken the joy of giving in everyone. The celestial beings bid him farewell, their hearts fulfilled. There is much work to do, he called back with a twinkle in his eyes. With that, the fireworks stopped. A warm, colorful glow radiated from Earth, and a peaceful white light shone above it from space. And then, planet Earth smiled.